Throughout the course of the day, I'm busy preparing my weathercast for you. I'm gathering together weather information so that when you turn on the TV, I'm going to have all of that weather knowledge ready for you throughout the course of my broadcast. We usually get about 2 to 3 minutes to tell you about what's going on with the weather. I have several things that I can share with you during the course of my weather broadcast. And my goal is to keep you informed as to what's going on outside, especially in the event of severe weather. Like one of the elements that I use to help me tell you what's going on with weather is our WeatherNet 3 sites. These are live weather reporting stations from across the Mid-South that give me the temperature, the wind speed, the wind direction, and as well as the rainfall, which is very important. Recently, we had some very heavy rain in the area, and the WeatherNet 3 sites show those for me. We also have some great camera shots that we can put into a little time-lapse action here so I can watch what's been going on. You can see the peaks of sunshine coming through across the area, and we have these situated all across the Mid-South, which really allows us a good view of what's going on across the region, especially when it comes to things like severe weather. If we had heavy storms moving through, these cameras would be able to pick that up as well. But these are invaluable to us in letting us know where winds are gusting from the north or from the south, and letting us know if cold fronts have moved through the area and where the heaviest of the rain or the gustiest of the winds may have been. My main computer that I use throughout the course of the day is this one right here. And when you see this map, this is our First Defense Doppler 3D radar. This is the one that will allow us to show you where the rain is falling, how heavy the rain is, and which direction it's moving in. Now, overnight, we had heavy rain move across the area. Right now, I don't have any stormy weather to tell you about, but if I did, I could zoom all the way down into what we call street level mapping to share with you where the storms are, which direction they're moving in, and where they're going to be throughout the course of the next hour to hour and a half. This is very important, especially when it comes to things like severe weather. Your safety is our number one priority, and it's very important for us to keep a very close eye on what's going on with these storms as they work their way across the area, with the cold fronts moving into the Mid-South, which direction the storms are moving. I can do all of this right here with my fingertips on top of the computer that we're at the moment. Now, here's the cool thing. I have several different maps that I will utilize in helping to explain to you what's going on with the weather. I have the radar, which shows the clouds and the rain, and then I also have a temperature map that'll show me what's going on with the temperatures across the area as well. This has been very, very helpful in showing you where the cooler air has been moving into the Mid-South, or whether or not the temperatures have been climbing from the south. Again, these are things I can fix on a daily basis and update when it comes to the forecast. Here's where it gets really exciting, because people ask me this question all the time. Walk with me now. I'm about to go in front of what's called our green screen, our chroma key wall. It's you look at it and you go, well, Todd, this isn't very exciting. You have a green wall over here and you have some monitors on both sides of you. But this is where I do most of my work. It's about to be magic. Are you ready? We go from the green screen over to the magic of television, which allows me to put things in back behind me. Isn't that cool? And with this, I'm able to share with you various parts of the Mid-South with not only the forecast maps, but also with the radar, letting you know where the cold fronts, the warm fronts are. And also, here, let me go get my little remote control. Very easy to walk in and out of that picture with no problem. You may have seen I had some monitors on both sides. Now I have my remote control in my hand. I try not to bring a lot of attention to this, but it's like a slideshow or a PowerPoint presentation that I will use to go ahead and change these maps, because I need to share with you different things that's going on. These are forecast models that tell me where the storms are, which direction they're moving in, and who is going to be most affected by them, whether it's going to be rain or storms or maybe just some gusting winds, but I'm always on the lookout for that threat of severe weather across the area and whether or not we're going to have to be dealing with those storms and for how long. This is very important because it can change around your plans. You're thinking about being outside. Maybe you're going to have to be inside, or at least have some indoor plans. Now I'm going to transition back over to what I like to call my weather pod. So we start over here. We're back in front of the chroma key. Remember I showed you this little monitor over here? You don't get to see that at home, but this helps me make sure that I'm looking and talking about the right place at the right time. And then I'm back over here in my weather pod, which is where I'm able to also, I wanted to show you a couple of different things, have some cameras to look outside to see what's going on. These cameras are very helpful. We have them around the Mid-South. We have one at the airport. We have one downtown. We have two of these cameras right here at News Channel 3. We have some out east and also a few attached to our weather in at three sites from across the area. By seeing what's going on outside, I'm in this studio and there aren't a lot of windows here for me to see what's going on outside. So these cameras really help me out in knowing what's going on with the weather. The most frequently asked question I get is, what time do you get to work? And I get to work about 3 o'clock in the morning. That's right, I have to wake up around 2, get here at 3, and then we go on the air around 4:30. But the good news is I get to leave most days by about 12:30 or 1. Now, if there's severe weather, that's a different story. I'm going to have to stick around until that severe weather threat is over with. But that's one of the questions that most folks like to know. What time do I go to bed? And it's whenever I can. So you get as much sleep as you can on this particular shift, which is the morning one. I love what I do here at the television station. Every day is something new. I gather together my weather knowledge. I put it together in a presentation form, and then I communicate that information with you on a daily basis so that you would know what's going on with the weather on that day. Do well in class. I'm very proud of you guys for studying the weather. Keep up the good work, and don't forget to email me any questions you might have about the weather.